Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to create a very basic applique in StitchArtist. Now, this is a capability that you will get even in StitchArtist Level 1. In order to access the StitchArtist features, we need to click on this button right here. This brings us into create mode. I'm first going to create an object, and there are a whole bunch of different ways to create an object, but in the interest of just keeping our focus on creating the applique, I'm just going to create one of these basic shapes. So I'll pick the circle and click and drag and create a circle or an oval. Now that's just an object. It doesn't have any stitches applied to it. If I want to create an applique, then all I have to do is select my object and click on this fourth button right here. And now I have an applique. Now you may not like that blanket stitch, that's not the traditional satin stitch that we're used to seeing that you might have expected, but that's okay. If you just switch your border setting over here to satin, now it looks like a satin stitch applique. Now by default, I'm gonna move my head over here. By default, the width is 3 millimeters. I tend to like my applique to be a little bit thicker. It does a better job of covering the raw edge of the fabric. Now, if I preview my design, you can see that there's one stitch line and then all the satin stitch. Now, some people like to do their appliques that way. They use this first bit of stitching for placement and then they just set their pre-cut applique file, fabric into that area and then they do the satin stitching. Me personally, the way I make all of my appliques, let's go back to create mode, is I like to have two rounds of stitching. So I'll select my, I like to have the placement stitching, then the tack down stitching, and then the final satin stitching. I can get that by just checking this box right here. So before it was unchecked, I just checked it. Now, if we go and preview the stitch out, you can see that these are very subtle differences in color right here, but I have the placement stitching, then I have the tack down stitching, and then I have the final satin stitching. So, and if I really wanted to stitch this out, all I would have to do is save the stitch file and then load it onto my machine. And that is how you create an applique file in Embrilliance StitchArtist.